Hello and welcome. My name is Manuel Quintana with Pragmatic Works, and in collaboration with MAQ Software, we're going to be looking at their fantastic custom visual known as the linear gauge. We're going to be using Power BI so we can explore all the fantastic and wonderful features available within this visual. So as we bring this custom visual from MAQ Software into Power BI, we can see some straightforward similarities with the out-of-the-box KPI gauge. Obviously, the main difference is where the gauge visual is more of a horseshoe shape. It's that arc. We don't have that here. It's linear. But the target value, the current value, you can choose the min and the max. Those are all that you could not do with the traditional out-of-the-box gauge. Here, we can do so much more, including as far as going into comparing progress against identified goals and warning zones. We can set up so that we can have indicators. So right now, this is the color for my indicator, showing I haven't made it. We can also have some nice legends in place to make the target more explicit. And we're going to see so many more options here. Let's bring up a more fully fleshed out example of this. Here we've got three different stores. And we know with things like a KPI or a gauge, the goal is to quickly look at something and understand if it's doing well or if it's not. There is a target. Are we meeting it or are we not? And we can very easily accomplish that. So the main purpose of this, secured. It's good. But we can see we get so much more information out of this. We do have some fantastic things, such as the scale here, which breaks down kind of the grouping before we get to that target. We do have the actual numeric amount of what we've accomplished. And we can see this is current. And we can see the actual value, but we can change the format of this, we'll see that momentarily, as followed with as well the percentage. And we can see our target up here. And also we have the capability of fitting in, and if we look at the field area, two different trend values. So we can add those into the mix with these little trends, which we can see that it tells us we have a positive incline here. And we can choose these little colors for this and everything like that. So let's actually look into the display area to see what options we have at our disposal. The first we're going to look at is the orientation. Now, of course, this is going to be dependent on how you've laid out your visuals, but if you didn't want to go horizontal, you need to save a little more space and go vertical. Yes, you can go ahead and do that, and you still get to retain all the information. We have orientation. We also have the capability of turning off the legend if you like, but usually visuals are all about transparency and explicitness, so it's fantastic being able to readily understand and see what our target is. And maybe you don't want that exact value, you want to display it differently. Of course, we have what we're used to, the different display features, so we can kind of summarize that to a degree. Beyond legends, we also have the target range. This is something that I have off, but if you wanted, you could turn this on and specify a min and a max value, and you'll have this target range identified within your gauge. So let's say I did something like 100,000 here, and then we did 120,000 here. By doing that, we're going to see these little red markers appear to indicate a certain target range. And we can, of course, increase or decrease the size of those ticks right here by range tick width if you just want to make it a little more pronounced. So it is driven by these manual values, but if you have an area that you want to specify, you want to indicate, you can do it here with target range. Scale, that is going to be this nice scaling of numbers you see down here at the bottom. We, of course, can increase the size if we need more visibility, or if you wanted to, you could completely turn this off. But I think it adds a nice little element to this. Indicator, of course, is going to be these items in the upper right-hand corner, which if we wanted to, we could change these colorations. It is a little bit tinier, but a little bit can make an impact. So choose what you would prefer as far as seeing those indicator values. We also have the capability of turning on zones. So you're going to see when we turn this on that we can specify up to four different zones. So basically, I would choose what is the top range for this first zone. So we'll just say it's 90,000, just like that. And you can see we get this little coloration over that first. And the second one, let's say that one goes up to 105,000, just like that. The zone three will make a little bit smaller. We're just going to go to 110. And then, of course, zone four, we'll bring it all the way to 100 and let's do it 120, just like that. And you can see it just adds this little bit of separation. Once again, you are manually dictating these values, but you can add a little more flavor now to that gauge. As well as this zone indicator here, we can also go into general. This is where we can choose if it's less than the value our current value is less than the target, what will be its coloration? For here, I have this like orange. And if it's greater, it's going to be green. We also have this capability of filling in a comparison. So if I go ahead and turn this red, it basically fills in what's left of that gauge. So basically, up to that maximum value as to the current value, it's going to fill that in with some dictated value if you want it to. So for me, I have left this white just because it's, I don't feel it's necessary, but it's a nice additional option you potentially could have at your disposal. And of course, you have all the other items at your disposal for turning off trends, percentages, actual values. You can format, you can do more displaying of units, all of this at your disposal. So definitely takes the gauge and just takes it to the next level. Thanks for watching this video. If you have any questions about this visual or need a similar business solution, feel free to contact MAQ Software at sales@maqsoftware.com. As well, for any of your Power BI training needs, be sure to reach out to us at Pragmatic Works by emailing us at training@pragmaticworks.com.